हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज इन्फॉर्म टू यू ऑल, वी आर स्टार्टिंग द कोचिंग क्लासेस फॉर सीईटी, जेईई एंड नीट. एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ द फर्स्ट पीयू चैप्टर फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ नीट एज वेल एज सीईटी. एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो, before starting the topic, I would like to give information with respect to what are the important chapters with respect to the NEET, especially in biology, what is the pattern of question paper in the NEET, and all the students who are dreaming to become doctors, how they have to prepare for the NEET exam with respect to all the subjects. Among them, the biology is most important because 90 questions are from the biology only. So let us move to the details of the chapter wise weightage of the biology with respect to NEET examination. So here is the detailed aspect. So NEET exam pattern, how it will be? Pattern of examination, pen and paper based. That means you need to mark the shade the right option. Duration of examination, 3 hours. Total number of questions, 180. In that, the 3 sections will be there. First section, physics, having 45 questions. Second section, chemistry, with 45 questions. Biology, third section with 90 questions. That means to get passing marks, eligible marks in the NEET, you need to concentrate more on the biology. And specifically, you have to follow the NCERT prescribed text, whether it is first PUC or second PUC, thorough reading and making the practice of NCERT based questions, NCERT based information syllabus. It is very important to crack the NEET exam in first attempt. So, scheme of valuation, how it is? 4 marks for each correct answer. If you mark the correct answer, if your one answer is correct, you are going to get 4 marks. Minus 1 mark for each wrong answer. If you mark the correct answer for one question, you will get 4 marks. At the same time, if you mark 4 wrong answers, every wrong answer, there will be deduction of 1 mark. So 4 wrong answers minus 4, 1 right answer plus 4. 0 mark for each unanswered question. If you don't attempt any question, neither it will be positive effect on your marks, or nor it will cause the negative effect on your marks. So 1 right answer plus 4 wrong answers minus 1 like that, all the 4 marks will be removed for the negative answering. This is called negative marking. So whichever the answer, if you are perfectly knowing that answer, then only you need to attempt. And you will get the perfection, you will get the confidence if you go on practicing the questions. And maximum NEET marks 720, whether it is 2020 or 2021, whatever the year, it will be 720 marks. Aggregate score calculation. Total number of correct answers into 4, total number of incorrect answers into 1. There are no marks for attempting of questions. If you attempt the question, there will be no grace. Only the correct answer or the wrong answer is taken into consideration. So especially for second PU students, I would like to inform, concentrate on first PU syllabus as well as the second PU syllabus, because 45 questions from the first PUC and 45 questions from the second PUC, you are going to get in the NEET examination. Again, I am stressing the same point. You need to concentrate on the NCERT prescribed syllabus for attempting the NEET exam. So this is the pattern of question paper. Then here is chapter wise weightage for biology. Here you will get the complete picture of NEET examination. What are the important chapters to concentrate to crack the NEET for the first time? Instead of going for the long term course, why don't you attempt properly for the first time to get through the NEET examination? Chapter wise weightage, here the topics are divided as botany and zoology. So in the botany part, plant diversity, here it is marked as red, plant anatomy blue, plant morphology, then cell biology and cell division, biomolecules, plant physiology. This light green color portion is indicating plant physiology. Most important part of first PUC, you are going to get more questions from this one in the NEET question paper. Plant reproduction, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants or life cycles of flowering plants, all that. This one is very important. Genetics and biotechnology, this is second year syllabus. Principles of inheritance, molecular basis of inheritance, evolution, then the biotechnology, principles and processes, applications. So one more part is ecology. Here if you compare, very least marks are distributed for biology in human welfare. That means minimum questions will be from this one. So for sure you need to make the practice of plant physiology topics of first PUC, genetics and biotechnology of the second PUC to attempt maximum questions. Apart from these two sections, one more part is very important, cell biology and cell division, and this one is also very important, plant reproduction. So these are the chapters that you need to concentrate to crack through the NEET examination for the first time, to get the very good result in NEET. These are the important chapters. And look at this image, chapter wise weightage for zoology in percentage, more than 50% it is represented by human physiology. All the chapters of human physiology of first PUC, digestion and absorption, breathing and exchange of gases, blood, body fluid and circulation, excretory products and excretion, neuronal control, locomotion, apart from that chemical coordination and integration, all the topics of first PUC are very 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 important to pass the NEET examination. This is the biggest part in the zoology from first PUC. Then next to that one is human reproduction and reproductive health. These are the second PUC topics. Then origin and evolution. Origin and evolution, this green portion is representing. And human health and diseases, this ash portion is representing here. Then that yellow part, very minimum number of questions, structural organization in animals. This red portion is representing with respect to animal diversity, that is chordate and non-chordate. So if you compare both the sections, plant physiology, genetics and evolution, plant reproduction, human physiology and human reproduction and reproductive health, these are the must and should topics to pass the NEET examination. This is the chapter wise weightage for botany as well as zoology. Then yes, how many percent of the questions, average number of questions from each topic are expected in the NEET question paper? So plant diversity, on an average 7 questions, that is 12%. Plant anatomy 2%. sorry, 2 questions 4%. Here I would like to concentrate plant physiology 8 questions, that is 13%. Genetics and biotechnology 15 questions, it is representing 24%. So these are the important chapters. Definitely we will get the idea after going through this chart, that idea you will get what are the important topics for the preparation of NEET. Like that, this is the chapter wise average weightage of the geology topics. Here you can see from the human physiology 13 questions are expected, 45% highest in the geology topics, so human physiology. On an average 13 questions are expected, and that is contributing for 45% of the human physiology. Then next to that one is human reproduction and reproductive health. 5 questions on an average are expected, and it is contributing for 18%. So here is the idea, what are the important topics in the biology for the preparation of NEET. Then let us move to the chapter wise analysis. Today I am going to deal with the first PU topic, that is the living world. And from 2010 to 2019, the analysis with respect to this chapter is given here. In 2010, no questions from the topic. 2014 also no questions. In the year 2016 and 13, little bit hike is there in the questions asked in the NEET examination. And all these are average, 12, 18 and 20. So from this particular chapter, the questions are asked with respect to taxonomic categories like kingdom, species, all these. The chapter utility score is 6.4%. So this is about the analysis of questions from the first chapter in first PUC, it is living world. So let us move to the details of this topic. Then I am going to deal with some selected questions from the given material which we have distributed in the college. If you get any doubt in the given material with respect to any other question, you can ask me at any time. So let us move to the details of the chapter 1 in the first PU biology, that is living world. What is life? Life is unique. It is complex organization of the molecules expressing through chemical reactions which lead to growth, development, responsiveness, adaptation and reproduction. Whenever the molecules are organized together, if they are able to undergo the chemical reaction and it leads to growth, development, responsiveness, adaptation and reproduction, all this is representing the unique condition called life. And in the entire universe, Earth is the only one planet which is supporting the existence of life. And on the Earth, the organisms are living in different habitats such as forest, mountains, desert, oceans, freshwater bodies, hot springs, polar regions, and almost every place of the Earth is occupied by the organisms. Then, the living organisms show some unique features, and they are growth, metabolism, ability to sense the environment, reproduction, cellular organization, and consciousness. All these are the unique characters shown by living organisms. Then moving to the next part, all living organisms, they show the growth. It may be increase in the mass or it may be increase in the number. The increase in mass and increase in number of the individuals are called twin characters of the growth. A multicellular organism increases its mass by cell division. The body weight or the body mass is increased in the multicellular organism with the help of cell division. If we compare the growth in plant and animal, in plants, the growth continues throughout the life in their meristematic area, but in animals, the growth occurs to a certain age. Till the end of the life, the animals are not growing, but due to the presence of meristematic cells, as the meristematic cells have the property to undergo continuous cell division, in the plants we can see the growth throughout their life. And unicellular organisms also show the growth, but for the growth they are dependent on division. So here it is the image of bacteria, and the image that you can see or that you can watch, what you are watching, it is showing binary fission. So in all the organisms, the unicellular organisms are also showing the growth, plants are showing the growth, even animals are also showing the growth. Then moving to the next one, living organisms show internal growth. Type of the growth which we observe in case of living organisms, it is called internal growth. And internal growth is always due to addition of materials and formation of cells inside the body. Whenever the cells undergo division, the new cells are produced, and as a result of formation of the new cells from the internal side, the growth occurs. Whereas the growth is also observed in the non-living things, but in non-living things the growth is external. Due to the addition of similar material, due to the deposition of similar materials from the outer surface or from the outside, on the outer surface, they also show the growth, but type of the growth that we observe in the non-living things is called the external growth. In the living organisms, the growth is internal, but in non-living organisms, in non-living things, the growth is external. Therefore, for the living organisms, growth is not considered as a defining property, because it is not only observed in the living, but it is also observed in the non-living things. Hence, it is not the defining property of living organisms. Then, reproduction, it is again a character of living organisms. And during reproduction, the existing organism produces the offspring similar to itself. In multicellular organism, the mode of the reproduction generally it is sexual, but organisms are also undergoing asexual reproduction. For example, in fungi, the asexual reproduction occurs by producing conidia. Then in case of yeast, the asexual reproduction occurs by budding. In case of hydra also, here you can see the images, the parental hydra produces the bud, and budding is a method of asexual reproduction. Apart from that, fragmentation is also a method of asexual reproduction that is observed in case of planaria. Then moving to the next one, even though the reproduction is a character of living organisms, but there are some living organisms, even though they are living in condition, but they are unable to undergo the reproduction. For example, mule, sterile worker honeybees, and infertile human couple. Even though they are living in condition, but due to some reasons, these organisms are unable to undergo the reproduction. Here you can see the image of mule, and mule is offspring of male donkey and female horse. As the two unrelated organisms are allowed to reproduce, donkey and horse are totally different from one another. The product of donkey and horse reproduction is mule, but this mule is sterile. What is the meaning of sterile? Sterile means unable to undergo reproduction. Then worker honeybees, they are highly working, workaholic organisms on the earth are nothing but honeybees. Always they are doing one or another kind of the work, and worker honeybees are also sterile in condition. Meaning of the sterile is unable to undergo reproduction. Then metabolism, the very very important character of the living organisms. Another character of the living is metabolism, which is defined as sum total of all the chemical reactions occurring in the body of an organism. And remember, because of these chemical reactions only, the organisms are showing growth, development and other functions. Because through the chemical reactions only, energy is released, and that energy is utilized for different activities along with the growth and development. All the organisms which are living in condition, like plants, animals, fungi, bacteria like microorganisms, are also able to show the metabolism. And one more very important thing to remember is no non-living objects show the metabolism. See, growth is shown by the non-living things, but it is external. Even though the organisms are in the living condition, but some living organisms like mule are unable to undergo the reproduction. Therefore, growth and reproduction are not the defining characters. Mule is living in condition, but at the same time it is unable to undergo the reproduction. In case of non-living things, the growth is taking place from the outer side. But metabolism is not like that. No non-living object shows the metabolism. Then you may ask the question, when you are doing the experiments in the laboratory, particularly in the chemistry lab, you are making use of chemicals. Whether these chemicals are living or non-living? The answer is chemicals are non-living. Then how can we say the metabolism is the only character shown by the living organisms? See, even though you are doing the reactions by making use of non-living chemicals, but when they interact in the test tube, the type of the reactions that are taking place between the non-living chemicals are the living reactions. There is an interaction, there is a response between two non-living chemicals. Therefore, even though the reactions are carried out in the laboratory, in vitro means in the laboratory, the acting materials are non-living, but the occurring reaction is living. Therefore, metabolism is considered or defined as the defining feature of all the living organisms without exception. Metabolism is surely a character of only living organisms. So mostly ಇದು ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿರಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತೀನಿ. ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಗಳನ್ನು ನೀವು ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತಿರೋವಂಥ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಏನವ? ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಅವ. ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅಲೌಡ್ ಟು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್, ಅವಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಗ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತವ. ಅಂದರೆ ಆ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಗಳ ಮಧ್ಯಕ್ಕೇನು ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ನಡೀತದೆ, ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಏನು ನಡೀತದೆ, ಅದು ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ನೀವು ಎರಡು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿರಿ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಎರಡೂ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲೇನೂ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಟುಗ್ಯಾದರ್, ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಟುಗ್ಯಾದರ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಟ್, ದೇ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಇವನ್ ದೋ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಔಟ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಬೊರೋಟ್ರಿ, ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್, ಬಟ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಕರಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ living organisms. So this is about metabolism. Then coming to the next one, consciousness. It is the ability of living organisms to sense their surrounding environment and respond to the environment stimuli, which could be physical, chemical or biological. Whenever the organism is responding to the surrounding environment, it may be through the physical stimulation, through the chemical stimulation or through the biological stimulation, somehow the organism is responding. And again, this is considered as the defining property of living. Say for example, here I have shown two images, sunflower and touch me not. Sunflower, always that flower turns towards the source of light. How it is possible? Because it is sensing the surrounding stimulation and it is showing the response. And very interesting plant is the touch me not. If you touch it, the leaves will be leaves undergo folding. That folding of the leaf due to the touch, again it is because of sensation of the touch. Due to sensing of the touch, due to feeling of that touch, the leaves show the folding in case of touch me not. That means the plants are also having the consciousness. Then the question is, when the patient is in the coma condition, whether it is said to be living or non-living. When the patient is in coma condition, he or she is described as brain dead, because control over the body will be completely lost and the individual is unable to sense the surrounding environment. There will be no sensation, no response to the touch like that. Therefore, the patient who is in a coma condition, he or she is considered as brain dead. So, metabolism and consciousness are the defining properties of living. Like that, one more very important character of the living is cellular organization. The cell is a basic unit of the life. Body of the organism is compulsorily made up of cell, whether it is unicellular organism or it is multicellular organism. Compulsorily, the body of the organism is made up of a cell. The plants are made up of plant cells, and animals, our close relatives, monkeys, the animals are made up of animal cell. That means body of every organism is made up of one or another type of the cell, whether it is unicellular or it is multicellular. The cell represents basic unit of the life. Group of the cells represents tissue. Group of the tissues represents organ. When many organs are working together, it represents organ system. When many organ systems are present together, it forms the body of living organism. And all these are the different grades of cellular organization. The same with respect to coma person, the explanation I have mentioned here. And all these are the different cellular organizations. Then, in the entire world, the variety of plants and animals are present. The types of organisms, the number and types of organisms present on the earth referred as biodiversity. What is the total number of described species? It is 1.7 to 1.8 million. Here, the image I have selected, all the different organisms are present and surviving only on the earth. And number of species described on the earth are 1.7 to 1.8 million. Then every organism is provided with the name. That naming is called nomenclature. The definition states that it is the standardization of the names of organisms such that an organism is known by the same name all over the world. Instead of giving the names in local language, instead of giving the names in the regular language what we use for the conversation, if all the organisms present on the earth are scientifically named, that name is considered as a standard name, and such standardization of the names is called nomenclature, because the common names or the vernacular names or the local names, they create confusion as they are varying from one place to another place. Here the two examples I have taken. See, Kannada olagu idakka baale hannu antu karitivi, Hindi kela antu karitara, in English it is called banana, but biological name of the banana, it is always and it is Musa paradisica. This will be constant all over the world. ಬಾಳೆಹಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ನೀವು ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಯಾವುದೇ ಭಾಗದೊಳಗೆ ಹೋದ್ರೂ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಬನಾನಾ? ಮೂಸಾ ಪ್ಯಾರಡೈಸಿಕಾ. ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಜೇನು ನೊಣ ಹಿಂದಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಮಧುಮಕ್ಕಿ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಏಪಿಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಕಾ. ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಜನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್, ಆಲ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. And the standardization of the names of the organisms itself is called nomenclature. Before naming, the classification of the organism is essential, and before classification the organism must be identified, and for the identification the characterization is very important. So in the characterization, about the characters of organisms is informed. How it appears externally, what is its internal structure, what is its developmental process, and how it is living in the environment. So all these informations are considered as characterization. Once the characterization is completed, it is possible to give the correct description of the organism, which is called identification. And after identification, the organisms are grouped into specific convenient categories, and that grouping is called classification. After classification only, the given names are standardized, and that standardization is called nomenclature. Characterization, identification, classification, nomenclature, these are the four basic processes of the taxonomy, and taxonomy is called the study of identification, classification and nomenclature of organism. Whether the identification is properly done or not, classification is properly done or not, nomenclature, their given names are properly standardized or not, all these things are verified in a specific branch called taxonomy. Then one more term of importance, systematics. It is derived from the Latin word systema. It means systematic arrangement, and systematics deals with the evolutionary relationships between organisms. So then coming to next part, Carolus Linnaeus, father of taxonomy, he wrote a book called Systema Naturae, and this is the book written by Linnaeus. Linnaeus introduced binomial nomenclature, and this system of providing a name with two components is called binomial nomenclature. This naming system is proposed by Linnaeus. What is that binomial nomenclature? Whichever is the scientific name, every scientific name contains two components, generic name and specific epithet or specific name. So giving two names, one name with two components is called binomial nomenclature, and this binomial system of naming is proposed and started by Carolus Linnaeus, who is called father of taxonomy. Then example, Mangifera indica, this is the scientific name of mango. Here Mangifera indicates genus name and indica represents species name. The scientific names ensure that each organism has only one name. Local names, as they are in the local languages, the scientific names are similar all over the world. That is why the nomenclature is most important. The rules for naming of the plants is given by ICBN, which stands for International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, and the scientific naming of the animals, the rules are given by ICZN, International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. So these are the organizations which are providing the rules for naming, and those rules are rules of nomenclature. Biological names are in the Latin and written in italics. They are Latinized or derived from Latin, irrespective of their origin. The first word in the biological name represents the genus, while the second component denotes the specific epithet. Both the words in biological name, when handwritten, are separately underlined or printed in italics to indicate their Latin origin. Remember, the printing of biological names in the italic form is to indicate that the names have Latin origin. The first word denoting the genus starts with a capital letter, while the species epithet start with a small letter. Here you can see in the Mangifera indica, only M is represented in the capital letter. Mangifera represents genus name, and first letter of the genus name is in the capital letter. And small i in the indica. This is first letter in the species name, and it begins or it starts with small letter. Only first letter of the genus name must be in the capital. Remaining all the letters, including the first letter of the species name, must be in the small letter. Then coming to the next one, name of the author appears after the specific epithet, that is at the end of the biological name, and is written in an abbreviated form. The scientist who proposed that biological name, his name can also be represented after the species name. For example, Homo sapiens, biological name of man. After sapiens, here in short form lin is given, and finally a full point is kept. That lin stands for Linnaeus. That means the biological name Homo sapiens, it is proposed by Linnaeus. Even for Mangifera indica also, the lin is mentioned. Mangifera represents genus name, indica represents species name, and lin is author name, and it is Linnaeus. Like this, the rules are given by ICBN and ICZN for the naming of plants and animals. Then moving to the next one, taxonomic categories. This is the part that you need to concentrate for the purpose of competitive exam. Classification is not a single step process, but involves hierarchy of steps in which each step represents a rank or category, and all the categories together constitute taxonomic hierarchy. So classification cannot be done with a single step. It requires many different steps of different rank, and representation of the classification using these ranks is called taxonomic hierarchy. Each category represents a unit of classification in the taxonomic hierarchy. It is also called Linnaean hierarchy, as it is proposed by Linnaeus. All categories together constitute taxonomic hierarchy. From starting to end, whatever the categories are used to represent the classification, all of them are together representing taxonomic hierarchy. A group of organisms occupying a particular category is called taxon. In every category, whatever the classifying unit is present, it is called taxon. Then The different taxonomic categories are: the highest rank is kingdom and the smallest rank is species. Kingdom, when it is divided, either it gives phyla or division. If it is animal kingdom, the classification of animal kingdom provides phyla and classification of plant kingdom provides divisions. The next rank is class, order, family, genus and species. If the taxonomic categories are represented in ascending order, it starts with species, next is genus, family, order, class, phylum or division, and finally the biggest category is kingdom. One thing you need to remember, as you move from species to kingdom, always the number of similarities between the group of organisms goes on decreasing. Keep this in your mind. If you are moving from kingdom to species, number of similar characters will increase. If you are moving from species to kingdom, exactly opposite character is observed. Number of similarities goes on decreasing as we move from species to kingdom. So these are the different taxonomic categories. Species, the lowest category, it is represented by the group of closely related organisms. Not only they are closely related, but they are capable of interbreeding to produce the fertile offspring. They have the capacity to undergo the reproduction. Even they are able to produce the offsprings which have the capacity of reproduction. And remember, concept of species, it is proposed by Mayer. Mayer proposed the concept of species. Genus, it is the aggregate of closely related species. When many closely related species are present, all of them are included under one genus. The example you can see here, scientific name of the potato, it is S. tuberosum. Here I have mentioned S for Solanum. Scientific name of tomato, Solanum lycopersicum. Scientific name of brinjal, Solanum melongena. All the three species are belonging to the same genus Solanum. Therefore, genus is represented by aggregation of closely related species. When two or more than two closely related species are present, they represent the genus. Then, like that, in the animals, Panthera, the biological name of the lion, Panthera leo. Leopard, it is Panthera pardus, and tiger, Panthera tigris. So Panthera genus, here it is having three species. That is why group of closely related species represents the genus. Then family, higher rank than that of the genus, and it is represented by related genera with less number of similarities. That's what I told. As we move from species to the kingdom, number of similarities between the organisms goes on decreasing. Example, the family Solanaceae includes the different genera like Solanum, Petunia and Datura. Family Solanaceae, it is the single family, but it is including three different genera. Solanum is also included in Solanaceae, Petunia is also included in Solanaceae, Datura is also included in Solanaceae. So family is represented by group of related genera. Like that, family Felidae, it includes genus Panthera. That genus Panthera includes lion and tiger, wild animals. The same family is including Felis, that is cat family. Cat is also included in the same family in which the lion and tiger are present. So one more here. Yes, next one, order. It is assemblage of related families higher than family. order polymonials, it includes two different families, convolvulaceae and another is solanaceae. Ipomea is example for the member of convolvulaceae and solanaceae example petunia. Like that, example of the order Carniora, it includes family Felidae of lion and family Canidae of the dog. Both of them are different families but included under one order. Then class, assemblage of related orders. Class Mammalia includes Primata and Carniora. There is a lot of difference between these organisms, but both of them are included in class Mammalia. Class Dicotyledonae, it includes Polymoniales and Sapindales. Then finally, the phylum or division. Phylum in animals, division in plants, it is the assemblage of related classes. Here, the phylum Chordata includes Amphibia, able to survive on land as well as in the water. Skin is completely moist. Then class Reptilia, no comparison at all. The skin is dry, creeping animals. But even though both of them are having the backbone, this is the only similar character. Why they are placed in the phylum Chordata? Aves, body is covered by feathers. Only two limbs are present. Warm-blooded animals, these are cold-blooded animals. Then man is also having backbone. These organisms are also having the backbone. This is the one similarity, only one. Why these unrelated, completely different organisms are placed in the same phylum? That is because of the presence of backbone. Then like that, in case of plant also, division Angiosperma includes two classes, class Dicotyledonae and class Monocotyledonae. Both of them are different because in dicots, the seed contains two cotyledons. In monocots, the seed contains only one cotyledon. Both of them are not related, but still they are plants. Both of them are producing the flower. Hence, they are included in the division Angiosperma. The biggest rank is kingdom. Highest category, it is represented by assemblage of various phyla or divisions. Kingdom Plantae includes angiosperms as well as gymnosperms. Even though they are completely different from one another, Kingdom Animalia includes both chordates and non-chordates, even though they are completely different from one another. So all these are the taxonomic categories from species to kingdom. Remember, as we move from species to kingdom, number of similarities goes on decreasing. Then coming to the next one, the classification of organisms with their taxonomic categories. Just to go through this classification, try to remember the scientific name of man, scientific name of housefly, scientific name of mango and wheat with respect to their family, order, genus, class, phylum, everything. Then last bit of the topic, taxonomical aids. These are the materials which are used to study the taxonomy, and different taxonomical aids are herbarium, botanical garden, museum, zoological parks, key, flora, manual, monograph and catalog. So herbarium, it is a storehouse of collected plant specimens which are dried and pressed, preserved on the sheet. The herbarium sheet, it contains minimum information about the plant, such as family name, botanical name, from which place it is collected, what is the name in English, and date of collection, place of collection, the person who collected that plant. All these are the informations mentioned at the corner of herbarium sheet. Then botanical garden. These are the specialized gardens which have collections of living plants for references, and plant species in these gardens are grown particularly for the purpose of identification, and each plant is labeled with its scientific name and family. Every plant in the botanical garden, you can see the name of that plant and to which family it is belonging. The famous botanical gardens are Royal Botanical Garden at Kew, Indian Botanical Garden, Hoar, West Bengal, National Botanical Research Institute, Lucknow in India. All these are the famous botanical gardens. Then museum. Here you can see the preserved plant and animal specimens, and they are usually preserved in the preservatives. The skeletal system may be preserved in the museum. Stuffed animals are available in the museum. Even insects boxes are also available in the museum. And small scale museums are generally observed in educational institutes such as school and colleges. Then next one is zoological park. Here the similar natural habitat is imitated for the conservation of animals, but under the human care. Here the living animals can be observed about their habitat, behavior and type of the food they consume. That information can be collected. I have shown Mysore Zoo image here, Sri Chamarajendra Mrugalaya of Mysore, and this is the lion couple of Mysore Zoo. Zoological parks are also the best taxonomical aids to know the behavior, food and the type of the environment they like to live. That can be collected through the zoological park. Then key, another very important taxonomical aid, but it is used for the purpose of identification of plants and animals. This point you need to remember. For what purpose key is used as a taxonomic aid? For the purpose of identification of plants and animals. And in the key, always there is a pair of contrasting characters called couplet. And each statement in the key is called a lead. And here I have shown a picture or example of key. Say for example, in the laboratory you are provided a vertebrate in your hand. So how to identify to which group that vertebrate is belonging? So let us start with the questioning. Does it have fur? Whether it is having fur, that means hair on its body, or not? Here there are two options, yes or no. That means the contrasting characters, contrasting means opposite characters are there, and that represents couplet. If the answer is yes, we will get a lead, it has mammal. If the answer is no, again there is one more question, does it have feathers? When it don't have the fur, there is a question whether it is having the feather or not. If the answer is yes, we will get the lead, bird. Further identification will be done in the group of birds. If the answer is no, again the two options, dry skin, moist skin, couplet. If dry skin is there, answer is reptile. If moist skin is there, once again there are two possibilities. It may be with the scales or without scales. If scales are present, the given vertebrate is fish. If the scales are absent, with the moist skin, without feather, without fur, the answer is amphibian. Like this, the keys are used for the purpose of identification of plant and animal, just for the identification purpose, and it is completely based on similarities and differences. Then moving to the next one, flora, monograph and manuals. The flora contains actual account of habitat and distribution. Habitat, how that plant appears, that is the information and the distribution of the plant. Both of them are published in the flora of one particular area. Particular area of a given area about the habitat and distribution of the plants, this information can be collected through the flora. So remember, in case of key only identification, flora information about the habitat and distribution of plants of given area. Then manual, useful in providing information for identification of names of species found in an area. Just for the identification of names, the manuals are helping. Then monograph, it gives information about only one taxon. Mono means single. About the single taxon, the detailed information is available in the monograph. Then this one is given in the material. Herbarium ICBN, International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. The standard size of herbarium is 11.5 to 16.5 inches. This is standard size of herbarium. And herbarium is considered as a dry garden. Why it is called dry garden? Because the plant materials are pressed and preserved on a sheet. So here some terms are given with respect to the herbarium: holotype, herbarium sheet on which the first description of a plant is based. The herbarium sheet on which the first description of the plant is available, it is called holotype. Then lectotype. In case holotype is lost, by chance holotype andra first description bardanta sheet lost aitu kalitu athwa eno damage aitu ant itkolana, second herbarium sheet prepared from the original plant, it is called lectotype. Aa original plant adde mattond herbarium maartara adanna lectotype ant karitara. Then neotype. In case holotype and original plant is lost, then the herbarium sheet is prepared from some other plant of the same species, it is called neotype. See, yavade ondu plant the first description na herbarium sheet mel en mention maartara adak holotype an karibeku. By chance a holotype lost aadre, second herbarium sheet it is prepared using the original plant, it is called lectotype. ಹೋಲೋಟೈಪ್ ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಹೋಗ್ಯದಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಆವಾಗ ಹೊಸದೊಂದು ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಶೀಟನ್ನು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅದೇ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟನ್ನು ತೊಗೊಳಿಕತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಏನು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತಾರ? ದ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್, ಅದೇ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸು ಬಟ್ ಬೇರೆ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟನ್ನು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನಿಯೋಟೈಪ್. ಫೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಟೈಪ್. ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಹೋಲೋಟೈಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಎನಿ ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಶೀಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ many plants of same species, holotype original plant eradu miss aadaga, many herbarium balashtu herbarium galanna prepare madodu edrinda many plants of same species, ade plant addu ade species addu balashtu herbarium galanna prepare madidra adaka syn type antu karitara. Isotype, it is a duplicate of holotype. In the presence of holotype, a second herbarium sheet is prepared from the original plant, it is called isotype. Holotype kalade illa, lossu agilla ada, but still hantade innondu herbarium anna exact ade original plant adde tagondu madidre adanna isotype antu karitara. Then paratype, additional herbarium sheet used in the first description of the plant is called paratype. It is prepared from some other plant of the same species having same variations. In paratype andra additional herbarium sheet used in the first description of the plant,
ಈಗ ಒಂದೇ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಲೋಟೈಪ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತದೆ. ಆ ಹೋಲೋಟೈಪದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಒಂದು ಶೀಟನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಎಡಿಷ್ನಲ್ ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಶೀಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೋಲೋಟೈಪ್ ಏನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಟೈಪ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಥೆರಾಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್. ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಸಿ ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ದ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದ ಒರಿಜಿನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಟ್ರೇಸ್ ದ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ನೇಮ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್? ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು, ಯಾಕೆ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸನ್ನು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದ ಒರಿಜಿನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಟ್ರೇಸ್ ದ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ನೇಮ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ದ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ದೆರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಎಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಡ್. ಒನ್ಸ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡನ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈಡ್. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಸಿ ದ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿಯಲ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಸಿಮಿಲಾರಿಟೀಸ್. ದ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನರಿ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ನ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ವೆನ್ಎವರ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡನ್ ಟೂ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನರಿ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಹೌ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಡಿ. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು. ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್, ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೀನಸ್, ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ, ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್, ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ದೇ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್. ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಜೀನಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್. ಈಚ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಅಸೈನ್ಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ದ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಫಾರ್ ಒನಿಯನ್ ಆರ್ ಅಲಿಯಂ ಸೀಪಾ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್, ಅಲಿಯಂ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಜೀನಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್. द सीपा अलियम सीपानो बयोलॉजिकल टर्म तगोंड्रे इट इस द बयोलॉजिकल नेम ऑफ ऑनियन पर्टिक्युलर एग्जांपल वळग अलियम ऐन इंडिकेट माड्तद जीनस रैंक इंडिकेट माड्तद सीपा इज इंडिकेटिंग द स्पीसीज रैंक एंड दिस अलियम सीपा इट बिलांग्स टू द फैमिली लिलियेसी एंड दैट रिप्रेजेंट्स फैमिली रैंक लिलियेसी फैमिली रिप्रेजेंट माड्तद एंड दैट इज आल्सो अ टैक्सॉन थस अलियम इज वन रैंक सीपा इज वन रैंक लिलियेसी इज अनदर रैंक Therefore, any classification, whether it is of plant or it is of animal, ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋಂಥ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಾಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ಏನನ್ನು ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನನ್ನು ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಫೈಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಡಿವಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ದೆನ್ Moving to the next question. The living organisms can be unexponentially distinguished from non-living things on the basis of their ability for interaction with the environment and progressive evolution, reproduction, growth and movement, responsiveness to touch. Yes, this is very interesting question. ಏನ್ ಕೇಳುತ್ತದೆ the question? ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸನ್ನು ಅನ್ಡೌಟೆಡ್ಲಿ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ಗಳಿಂದ ಯಾವ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ವಿಶ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಯುನಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಎನ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ reproduction, growth and movement, responsiveness to touch. Here, growth and movement are not the distinguishing characters. Because already in the synopsis I explained, even though some organisms are living in condition, but they are unable to undergo the reproduction such as mule and worker honeybees. They are sterile organisms. Then interaction with the environment and progressive evolution. See, evolution is not only occurring in the living organisms. Jeeva vikasa anodo bari organisms olaga matra aglikattilla. Adu environment olaganu aagtirutade. And that change which is occurring in the environment, sometimes it is supportive for the biological evolution. And sometimes it is unsupportive for the biological evolution. Then interaction with the environment. ಇದು ಯಾಕೆ ಆಗಂಗ್ಲ ಈಗ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೋಮಾ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಅ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಆರ್ ವೆನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೋಮಾ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ವೈಟಲ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ವೆಂಟಿಲೇಟರ್ ಈಸ್ supplied or on the patient is on ventilator so saline will be supplied no intake of the food and the person who is in coma unable to respond either to the internal stimulation or to the external stimulation avrige hasivagiddu gortagangla yavade tharadu external stimulation touch agli pin madodagli prick madodagli nothing can be identified So the right answer for this question is undoubtedly with respect to living organisms, comparison with the non-living things, the distinguishing character in the given options is responsiveness to the touch. So this is the significant observation found only in the living organisms. So the answer for this question is option D. Then moving to the Next question. The sum total of chemical reactions occurring in our body is called. It is a direct question. With respect to the definition, it is given. The sum total of chemical reactions occurring in our body, it is called the metabolism. The metabolism represents the sum total of all the chemical reactions occurring in the body of an organism. Some of the chemical reactions are anabolic reactions, constructive reactions, and some of the chemical reactions are destructive reactions. Destructive in the sense there will be breaking down of molecules, but both of them are together representing the metabolism. Actually, nanu initially ne helbekagittu, but somehow I missed. Let me inform. So, neevu yavude competitive exam, whether it is CET or NEET, if you consider biology question paper, there you will get some specific types of questions. Some questions will be based on a definition, some questions will be with respect to the diagram, some questions on the match the following, some questions are reasoning questions, and some questions which one is the correct statement, true or false like questions, and some questions are the assertion and reasoning questions. These are the different patterns of the questions that you are going to get in CET exam question paper as well as in the NEET question paper. So let us move to the next question. Which of the following biological processes do not operate within the lifespan of an given organism? Birth and nutrition, growth and maturation, metabolism and excretion, decomposition and mineralization. Very interesting question again. Which of the following biological processes do not operate within the lifespan of a given organism? Even the living organism other, ee kottantha yavu processes adarda lifespan mugiyo tanaka nadiyodilla anta prashne. Birth and nutrition, yes, they are the part of lifespan. Birth adrane lifespan continue aagtada, because lifespan andre yen define maartiri, period of an organism from its birth to natural death. After the birth only the lifespan begins, and adu belithirbekadre it is getting the nutrition, adakke body ge nutrition beke beko, and after the birth the individual undergoes growth, and finally it attains the stage of maturity. And on the organism living condition olag ada antandra adra body olag chemical reactions aagtirtava, that is metabolism is taking place and the waste products are removed from the body, it is nothing but excretion. So you muru, birth and nutrition, growth and maturation, metabolism and excretion, these are taking place within the lifespan. Badukirbekadrene ivu muru nadithava, then which one is the answer? The processes that are not taking place during the lifespan are decomposition and mineralization. Ivu eradu after the death aagtava, whether it is a plant or it is animal, both decomposition and mineralization are taking place after the completion of lifespan. What happens in the decomposition? It is the process by which dead organic substances are broken down into simple organic or inorganic matter such as carbon dioxide, water, simple sugars and mineral salts. After the death of organism body, a body olagiddantha organic substance galu with the help of decomposers, both bacteria and fungi, they are converted or broken down into simple organic matter agabahudu, inorganic matter agabahudu, and they are added to the soil. So decomposition anodu after the completion of lifespan, andra organism galu death aad mele nadiyuvanta vandu process. In mineralization andri enu, it is synonymous with ultimate biodegradation or complete biodegradation. Yavude organic material sattaga adu decomposer galinda complete agi break agi soil ge add aagtidre biodegradation antu karitara. Microorganisms, if they are acting on the organic substance and they are converting it as a simple one, it is called biodegradation. Then finally, whatever the mineral salts are produced during the decomposition, they are added into the soil. Finally, after mineralization, the compounds, whether it is a nitrate, phosphate, chloride, fluoride, ammonia, sulfide, whatever it is, all of them are finally added into the soil. Actually, during decomposition, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಗಳು ಬರ್ತಾವ. ಒಂದೇ ಸಾರಿಗೆ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ಇನ್ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಡೌನ್ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೀಚಿಂಗ್, ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್, ದೆನ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್, ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಿನರಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಡಿಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ನಾಗ ಏನದ, ಮಿನರಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದು ಮಿನರಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಮಿನರಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್, ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಫರ್ಟಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್. ಸೊ ಬೋತ್ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಿನರಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾನ್. ಜೀವಂತಿದ್ದಾಗ ಇವೆರಡು ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳು ಸತ್ತ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಎಸ್, growth, development and functioning of a living body is due to ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಅದರ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನಡಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್? ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್. ಆವಾಗಲೇ ಒನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇದು ಬಂದಿತ್ತು ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಬಟ್ ಬೇರೆ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ. ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್. ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ನಡೀತಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ದೇರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್, ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಿಂಗ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್, ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಈ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನಡೆದಾಗ್ಲೇ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈಸ್ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ growth, development and different functions of the body. So the answer for this one is metabolism. Then moving to the next question. Practical significance of taxonomy is yak maadbeku taxonomy na athwa yak taxonomy na study maadbeku? Classification, to understand the diversity, to understand the evolution, identification of organisms. See, practical significance of taxonomy. So I explained what are the four basic principles of taxonomy: characterization, identification, classification and nomenclature. Andre taxonomy olaga first importance kododu yedaka? For the identification of organism. So practical significance of taxonomy is to identify the new organisms. After identification only, the names are given to the identified organisms, then it is subjected to classification, and classification is based on the similarities and differences. Already existing organism galu jothege compare maadtara, compare maadi similarities enava, differences enava, on the basis of similarities and differences finally the organisms are classified. Therefore the identification, the first step in taxonomy is identification, and it is dealing with the procedure of classification of organisms based on their similarities and differences. So practical significance of taxonomy is the identification, because after identification only the organisms are classified. Then moving to the next question, it is taxonomic hierarchy refers to stepwise arrangement of all categories for classification of plants and animals, A group of senior taxonomists who decide the nomenclature of the plants and animals, a list of botanists and zoologists who have worked on the taxonomy of a species or group, classification of a species based on fossil record. What is a taxonomic hierarchy? So, definition of taxonomic hierarchy indicates that classification is not a single step process. It is a stepwise process in which the different ranks or categories are used to represent the classification, and all those categories are together considered as taxonomic hierarchy. There will be change in the rank in every step. See, for example, if you consider the kingdom as the taxonomic rank, it is highest rank. If you consider the species as a taxonomic rank, it is the lowest rank. So that in the classification, every rank it is having different, every category is having different rank. Therefore, the answer for this question is taxonomic hierarchy is stepwise arrangement of all the categories of classification of plants and animals. This is also known as the Linnaean hierarchy. Idanna Linnaean hierarchy antanu karitara. And to represent the classification, these are the following taxonomic categories, starting from kingdom, the next is phylum, class, order, family, genus, and finally we will get the species. Among these ranks or categories, kingdom is the highest rank and species is the smallest rank. So this is the answer for the question. Then moving to the next one. Karyotaxonomy is a modern branch of classification which is based on numerical taxonomy, chemotaxonomy, karyotaxonomy. So finally, taxonomy is concerned with the identification, nomenclature and classification. But adrolage svalpa branch galanna nortivi. Karyotaxonomy is a modern branch of classification which is based on organic evolution, number of nuclei, number of chromosomes, trinomial nomenclature. How to understand what is the right answer? Taxonomy anto enu change agilla as it is term. Karyo with respect to karyon. Karyon antandre content present in the nucleus. Nucleus valage enu present ada? What is the content of nucleus? Very simple, the nucleus contains chromosomes. When the classification of organisms is made on the basis of number of chromosomes, it is called karyotaxonomy. See here, taxonomy is the branch of science which deals with the naming and classification of living organisms on the basis of similarities and dissimilarities. Karyotaxonomy deals with the classification of living organisms on the basis of structure of the nucleus, then the chromosome number. This is the main criteria considered. Structure of chromosome, size and shape of the chromosomes are the attributes which are used for classification. Karyotaxonomy na consider madkondu classification madtirbekadre alli main concentrate madodu edra bagge, with respect to the number of chromosomes, structure of the chromosome, size and shape of the chromosome. These are the main characters taken into consideration for the classification of organisms with respect to karyotaxonomy. Then moving to the next question. Who developed the key for identification of animals? What is key? It is taxonomical aid. And key valaga en madtivi? It helps in the only identification of plant and animal, and key contains a pair of contrasting characters called couplet. Every hint in the key is called lead. The key for the identification of animals na yar introduce madidro, John Ray, he used the key for the identification of plants and animals. So the right answer for this question is John Ray. See, John Ray proposed the classification of plants in his book Historia Plantarum, which was an important step towards modern taxonomy. The key is a device used by biologists for identifying organisms, unknown organisms on the basis of similarities and differences. Systematics rely on keys to help identify organisms and determine whether they have discovered the new organism entirely. ಈ ಕೀ ಬಳಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೊಸ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ನ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಯಾರೋ ಇಲ್ಲೋ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಎಕ್ಯುರೇಟಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಕೀನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡವರು ಯಾರು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಫಾರ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್, ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಾನ್ ರೇ. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಟು kingdom in a taxonomic hierarchy, the number of common characters will decrease, will increase, remain same, may increase or decrease. The answer is will decrease, because species in the kingdom ige ulta hodre, ascending order valaga hodre, the number of similarities goes on decreasing. ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸಿಮಿಲಾರಿಟೀಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಲಿ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಈಗ ನೀವು ಜೀನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್, ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಜೀನಸ್. ಅದ್ರ ಮ್ಯಾಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಜನರ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಜೀನಸ್ಸಿಂದ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಜೀನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ದಿಂದ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸಿಗೆ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸಿಂದ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಮಿಲಾರಿಟೀಸ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಎಸ್, ನೀಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅರೈಸಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಇಟ್. Classification help in knowing the relationship among the different groups of organisms. It is not possible to study every organism, all of the above. What is the need for proper system of classification? Now classification madlebeka athwa madbeku anodadre yaaka ond proper system of classification bekaagtada? Because ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್, ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಕಾಲದೊಳಗೆ ಬದುಕಿದ್ದಂಥ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು, ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಡೈನೋಸಾರ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಡೈನೋಸಾರ್ನ ನಾವು ಎದರೊಳಗೆ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಪ್ಟೈಲ್ಸ್, ರೆಪ್ಟೀಲಿಯಾಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅದು. ಡೈನೋಸಾರ್ಗಳನ್ನು ರೆಪ್ಟೈಲ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ? ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್. Classification helps in knowing the relationship among different groups of organisms. Andra evolutionary relationship bagge classification information kodutada, and every organism anna study madodantu possible ille illa. So hangagi classification ige enada, what is the need for classification? Andra answer is all of the above. ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ನನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ನು ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ, ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಂಥ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಯಾವು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಯಾವ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೂ ನಮಗೆ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ನು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಬೌವ್. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. ಎಸ್, ICVCN, ಇದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ, ಈಸ್ ಆನ್ ಎಬ್ರಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್, ನಿಮಗೆ ಐ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಎನ್ ಗೊತ್ತು, ಐ ಸಿ ಝಡ್ ಎನ್ ಗೊತ್ತು, ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬೊಟಾನಿಕಲ್ ನಾಮಿನಿಕ್ಲೇಚರ್, ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜುವಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ನಾಮಿನಿಕ್ಲೇಚರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ICVCN. ಐ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್, ಇದರೊಳಗಂತೂ ಏನೂ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕೋಡ್, ಇದರೊಳಗೂ ಏನೂ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಎನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾಮಿನಿಕ್ಲೇಚರ್, ಇದರೊಳಗೂ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೊಸ ಯಾವವ ಇಲ್ಲ, ವಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಫಾರ್ ವೈರಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಸಿ ವಿ ಸಿ ಎನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ವೈರಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾಮಿನಿಕ್ಲೇಚರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಬ್ರಿವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಐ ಸಿ ವಿ ಸಿ ಎನ್. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಡಿಫರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್, ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಅ ಹೈಯರ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ದೆನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್, ಲೋವರ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ದೆನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್, ದ ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್, ದ ಸಿಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್. ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಒಂದೇ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತದೆ. ನಾವು ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅಟ್ ಎ ಟೈಮ್ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಅಂತ ಕರೀಬೇಕು. ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್. ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸಿಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ ಒಳಗೆ ನೀವು ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಇಂದ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ವರೆಗೂ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಎವ್ರಿ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆರ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಓ, ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯಸ್. ಕರೋಲಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಾದರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ. ಬುಕ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮಿಯಾ ನೇಚರೇ ಅನ್ನೋ ಬುಕ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹೀ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಟು ನೇಮ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಾದರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ ಕರೋಲಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯಸ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಜೂಲಿಯನ್ ಹಕ್ಸ್ಲಿ. ನ್ಯೂ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಟರ್ಮನ್ನು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಜೂಲಿಯನ್ ಹಕ್ಸ್ಲಿ. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಎ ಪಿ ಡಿಕಾಂಡಲ್ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತದೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಬೆಂಥಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹುಕ್ಕರ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದರು. ಲೀನಿಯಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ, ಜೂಲಿಯನ್ ಹಕ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಕ್ವೈನ್ಡ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎ ಪಿ ಡಿಕಾಂಡಲ್ ಕ್ವೈನ್ಡ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ. ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಟರ್ಮನ್ನು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಯಾರು ಅಂದರೆ ಎ ಪಿ ಡಿಕಾಂಡಲ್. ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದು. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ರ್ಯಾಟಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಟಸ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟೋನಿಮ್ಸ್, ಟ್ಯಾಟೋನಿಮ್ಸ್ ಸಾರಿ ಟಾಟೋನಿಮ್ಸ್, ಸಿನೋನಿಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೋಮೋನಿಮ್ಸ್. ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಟೋನಿಮ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ನೀವು ಬಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ನೇಮ್ಸನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಜೀನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ಸು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಒಳಗರೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಮ್ಯಾಂಜಿಫೆರಾ ಇಂಡಿಕಾ ಬೋತ್ ಜೀನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೋಮೋಸೇಪಿಯನ್ಸ್, ಅರಾಚಿಸ್ ಹೈಪೋಜಿಯಾ, ಏಪಿಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಕಾ, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಒಳಗೆ ತಗೋರಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಜೀನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಟಾಟೋನಿಮ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಟಾಟೋನಿಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಬೋತ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಎರಡು ಜೀನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ದ ಹೆಸರಿಗೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ರ್ಯಾಟಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಟಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ ಆ್ಯನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಟಾಟೋನಿಮ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಜೀನಸ್ ಅದೇ ಜೀನಸ್ದ ಟೈಪ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಸೊ A number of animal species, however, have the same names for both genus and species, which creates a scientific name known as tautonym. Genus and species, yaradu name galu same idre, adanna tautonym anta karitara. Apart from ratus ratus, illa innu kelavu example galanna mention madini. Wolverine, its biological name is Glo-Glo, and this is the animal. Red fox, Olpes, and moose. Idu jinke tharaddu prani, LS. So these are the other examples of the animal names for tautonym, where both genus and species names are same. Then next question. An organism is in the same class but not in the same family. It may belong to the same. ಈ ಥರದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಇಟಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಭಾಳ ಸರಿ ಬಂದಾವ. ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಹೈರಾರ್ಕಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಹೌದಾ? Group of species, genus. Group of different related genera, it is a family. Group of related family is order. And group of related orders belonging to the class. Even the organism same class olagada, but bere family olagada andra, it may belong to the same order. Yaka? Order is assembly of families. ಅದು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾವ. ಆ ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗಳನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸಿ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ಆರ್ಡರ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ? ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಆನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ಸ್. ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಮು ಒಂದೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಒಳಗದ ಸೇಮ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ದ ಡಿಸ್ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೇಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಬಳಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ? ದ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಮೇ ಚೇಂಜ್. ಒನ್ ನೇಮ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲಿ. One species may have several common names and one common name may be applied to two species. Last option, all of the above. Yes, the answer is all of the above. Because common names are varying from one area to another area. They are changing from one place to another place. ಈಗ ನಾವೇ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಉಳ್ಳಾಗಡ್ಡಿ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಕನ್ನಡ ಒಳಗೆ. ಅದೇ ನೀವು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಮಂಡ್ಯ ಸೈಡ್ ಹೋದರೆ ನೀರುಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಆನಿಯನ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಮಿಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಲೋಕಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎರಡು ಹೆಸರು ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಎರಡು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಒಂದೇ ಹೆಸರಲ್ಲೇನೋ ಕರೀತಿರಬಹುದು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೇಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೂ ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ದ ನಾಮಿನಿಕ್ಲೇಚರ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡೈಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೋನಮಿಕ್ ಏಡ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಆನ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ಏನು ಕೇಳ್ಯಾರ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಒಳಗೆ? ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಆನ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಒಂದು ಏರಿಯಾ ಒಳಗೆ ಬರೋಹಂಥ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ಗಳ ನೇಮ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಂಥ ಯಾವ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೋನೊಮಿಕ್ ಏಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ? ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯೂಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್. ಯಾವುದು ಅಂತ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಫ್ಲೋರಾ, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯೂಲ್ ಮೊನೋಗ್ರಾಫ್ನಾಗ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪಿಸೀಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಎಸ್, ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ ವೇರ್ ಮೆಡಿಷನಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್. ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ ವೇರ್ ಹರ್ಬೇಷಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್. ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕಿಲ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್? ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೋನೊಮಿಕ್ ಏಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರೈಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್ಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೂಟ್ ಆಗೋಹಂಥ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವುದದ? ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್. ಇವನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೋಲೋ ಟೈಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಗ್ರೋತ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್. ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್. ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್, ಸಮ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್, ಕಾಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್? ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಥರ್ಡ್, ಫಾರ್ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್, ಫಾರ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಡ್. ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್ ಶೀಟ್ ಈಸ್. ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್, ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಹರ್ಬೇರಿಯಮ್ ಶೀಟ್ ಈಸ್ 11.5 inches into 16.5 inches. This is the standard size of herbarium sheet. Then, yes, this is the new one. The taxon court is used in between which of the following two taxa by paleontologists? Paleontology. Paleontology means the study of fossils. Fossils na study madohanta ondu branchige paleontology anta karitar. And that paleontology, it concentrates on the extincted organisms which are available in the form of fossil. ಯಾವುದು ಫಾಸಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇರ್ತದ ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಾಮನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೋನೊಮಿಕ್ ಕೆಟಗರೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, ಆರ್ಡರ್, ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ, ದೆನ್ ಡಿವಿಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್. ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ and it is used for the group of animals of the same species identified by a common character which is studied over a period of times as part of scientific or medical investigation. A group of related organisms for a long period of time, ಅದು ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಗೇಷನ್ನಿಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಥ ಒಂದು ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇದನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರು, ಹಳೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಒಳಗೆ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಕಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಬಟ್ ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ taxon is not used between class and order. Paleontologists make use of this taxon between class and order. Then choose an appropriate option to complete the given statement. In plants, growth takes place by dash throughout their lifespan. In plants, growth takes place by cell multiplication throughout their life span. ಯಾಕೆ ತೊಗೊಂಡೆ ಸೆಲ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಟಿಪ್, ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಟಿಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಟಿಪ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಡಿವಿಜನ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ cell multiplication. Then moving to the next question, which set of organisms reproduce by asexual mode of reproduction, and particularly it is mentioned fragmentation. Fragmentation nano asexual method danne use madkondo yav organisms asexually reproduce madtava. ಬರೇ ಎಸೆಕ್ಚುವಲಿ ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ, ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಸೆಕ್ಚುವಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಂಗೈ ಫಿಲಾಮೆಂಟಸ್ ಆಲ್ಗೆ, ನಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ಗೆ, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಿಲಾಮೆಂಟಸ್ ಆಲ್ಗೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋನಿಮಾ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಸಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಫಿಲಾಮೆಂಟಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಯೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್. These are particularly reproducing through the fragmentation, which is a mode of asexual reproduction. Then next question, which of the following shows the correct example of taxonomic category genus? Potato, tomato, brinjal belongs to Solanum. Monkey, gorilla, gibbon are placed in mammal. Solanum, Petunia and Datura are placed in Solanaceae. Mangifera, Indica, Solanum, Tuberosum and Panthera, Leo. ಏನ್ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಏನದ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರಿ ಜೀನಸ್. ಜೀನಸ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದು ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ? ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಟೋ, ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟೋ, ಬ್ರಿಂಜಾಲ್. They are belonging to the genus Solanum. Solanum is the genus which includes potato, tomato and brinjal. Mammalia yakalla idu class name ada, Solanaceae family name ada, and all these are the biological names indicating genus as well as species. Yaradu ova ille, so hangagi genus vandanne represent martirodu yavudu? Solanum, which includes potato, tomato and brinjal. Then so these are the questions that I wanted to discuss with respect to the living world. Hope this explanation is clear for you. Thank you.